Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. We are discussing on properties of steam, and this is lecture number 505. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the properties of steam, the various process with the steam, and we solved a few problems on the properties of steam and process of steam. And we will continue here with the problems. So we will solve few more problems on the properties of steam and the learning outcome to the learner, to the student. At the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems on the properties of steam. And this is example number 8. From the Anna University question paper, November 2016, a steam boiler initially contains 5 metric cube of steam and 5 metric cube of water at 1 megapascal. The steam is taken out at constant pressure until 4 metric cube of water is left. What is the heat transfer during this process? So the given data, Vg equal to 5 meter cube, Vf equal to 4 meter cube, and pressure is equal to 1 megapascal, which is 10 bar. Final volume of water, Vf equal to 4 meter cube. And from the steam table, at the pressure P equal to 10 bar, Ts equal to 179.9 degrees Celsius, Vf equal to 0.001127 meter cube per kilogram, Vg equal to 0.1943 meter cube per kilogram, Hf equal to 762.6 kilojoules per kilogram, Hfg equal to 2013.6 kilojoules per kilogram, and Hg equal to 2776.2 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the internal energy of the steam, internal energy of the water, Uf equal to fluid, Uf equal to Hf minus P into Vf, which is 762.6 minus 10 into 100 into 0.001127 equal to 761.473 kilojoules per kilogram, and Ug, specific internal energy of the vapor steam, Hg minus P into Vg, this equal to 2776.2 minus 10 into 100 into 0.1943 equal to 2581.9 kilojoules per kilogram. And this is the initial condition of the boiler. So initially we have 5 meter cube of water and 5 meter cube of steam at the pressure 1 megapascal. Finally, again the pressure is the same, but the water quantity is 4 meter cube. The remaining quantity is, remaining volume is the vapor. So, initial mass of steam and water. So, Vf by capital Vf, volume of the liquid divided by specific volume of the liquid plus volume of the vapor divided by the specific volume of the vapor equal to 5 divided by 0.001127 plus 5 divided by 0.01943 equal to 4436.5 plus 25.73. Final mass of steam and water. So, this is again the formula is the same, capital Vf divided by small Vf plus capital Vg by small Vg. Now, volume of the fluid now 4 meter cube. And corresponding Vf equal to 0.001127 plus remaining volume is occupied by the steam now. So, 6 divided by 0.1119.43, which is 3549.2 plus 30.88. So, mass of the steam taken out from the boiler. So, Ms equal to, so this value minus this value. So, this is 4436.5 plus 2573 minus 3549.2 plus 30.88 equal to 882.15 kilogram. So, the mass of the steam taken out from the boiler is 882.15 kilogram. So, writing the energy balance, initial energy stored in the water and the steam plus amount of heat transfer, that is equal to final energy stored in the water and the steam plus energy leaving with the steam. So, we are taking certain quantity of steam and we assume that the steam is taken with the dry saturated condition. So, energy leaving with the steam. So, initial internal energy is Ui plus heat transfer equal to Q. Final internal energy is Uf plus energy leaving with the steam Ms into Hg. So, we assume that the steam leaves is dry saturated steam. So heat transfer during this process, Q equal to UF minus UI plus MS into HG. So UF, that is mass of the water into specific enthalpy of water. So 3549.2 into 761.473 plus mass of the vapor into specific internal energy of vapor, that is 3088 into 2581.9. Then UI initial, so mass of the liquid into specific internal energy of the liquid. So 4436.5 into 761.473 plus mass of the vapor into specific internal energy of vapor. So 25.73 into 2581.9 plus mass of the steam taken out, 882.15 kilogram into enthalpy equal to 2776.2. So solving this equation, so Q equal to, so the first value is 2.78 10 power 6, the second value minus 3.44 in 10 power 6, and the third value 2.45 in 10 power 6. So finally, 1.79 into 10 power 6 kilojoules. So that is the amount of heat transfer during this process, 1.79 in 10 power 6 kilojoules. The ninth problem from the university question paper, May 2013, steam at 30 bar and 350 degrees Celsius expanded in a non-flow isothermal process to a pressure of 1 bar. The temperature of and the pressure of the surrounding are 25 degrees Celsius and 100 kilopascal respectively. Determine the maximum work that can be obtained from this process per kg of the steam. Also find the maximum useful work. So given data, pressure P1 equal to 30 bar, T1 isothermal process, this is isothermal process. So, T1 equal to T2 equal to 350 degrees Celsius. So, P2 equal to 1 bar. Surrounding temperature TO equal to 25 degrees Celsius, which is 298 Kelvin. And the surrounding pressure is PO equal to 100 kilopascal. So, the steam is superheated. Referring to the steam table at 30 bar, the saturation temperature. Actually, the temperature of the steam is more than the saturation temperature. The steam is superheated, both at inlet and the outlet condition. So, from the steam table, at the P1 equal to 30 bar and T1 equal to 350 degrees Celsius, H1 equal to 3117.5 kilojoules per kilogram and V1 equal to 0.09053 meter cube per kilogram and S1 equal to 6.747 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And again, from the steam table, P2 equal to 1 bar and T2 equal to 350 degrees Celsius, H2 equal to 3175.6 kilojoules per kilogram, V2 equal to 2.81 metric cube per kilogram, and entropy equal to 8.386 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now we calculate the internal energy of the steam. So initial internal energy U1 equal to H1 minus P1 V1, which is 3117.5 minus 3000 into 0.09053 equal to 2845.31 kilojoules per kilogram. So 3000, so 30 bar into 100, so 3000 here, and the U2 equal to H2 minus P2 V2, which is 3175.6 into, this is 1 bar, which is 100 kilopascal, so 100 into 2.871 equal to 2888.5 kilojoules per kilogram. So minimum work done, maximum work done, so Wmax equal to U1 minus U2 minus PO into S1 minus S2. So, substituting the values, U1 equal to 2845.91 minus U2 equal to 2888.5 minus TO equal to 298 plus into S1 equal to 6.747 minus 8.386 equal to 445.83 kilojoules per kilogram. The maximum useful work, WU maximum equal to U1 minus U2 plus PO into V1 minus V2 minus TO into S1 minus S2. Substituting the values, U1 equal to 2845.91 minus U2 equal to 2888.5 plus PO equal to 100 into V1 equal to 0.09053 minus V2 equal to 2.871 minus TO equal to 298 Kelvin multiplied by S1 equal to 6.747 minus S2 equal to 8.386. So, using the calculator, calculating the value, the maximum useful work equal to 167.785 kilojoules per kilogram. So the maximum work equal to 445.83 and maximum useful work equal to 167.785 kilojoules per kilogram. And we take example number 10, the steam at a pressure of 15 bar and 250 degrees Celsius expands according to the law PV to the power 1.25 equal to constant to a pressure of 1.5 bar. Evaluate the final condition, work done, heat transfer and change in entropy. The mass of the steam equal to 0.8 kilogram. So, this is from November 2019 question paper. So, the given data, the process is polytropic process, P1 equal to 15 bar, T1 equal to 250 degree Celsius, pressure P2 equal to 1.5 bar and polytropic index N equal to 1.25. So, from the steam table, the properties of the superheated steam at the pressure P1 equal to 15 bar and T1 equal to 250 degree Celsius, the H1 equal to 2923.5 kilojoules per kilogram and the V1 equal to 0.152 meter cube per kilogram, entropy S1 equal to 6.71 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and the final volume of the steam, so V2 equal to V1 into P1 by P2 to the power 1 by N. So, 0.152 into 15 by 1.5 divided to the power 1 by 1.25 equal to 0.959 meter cube per kilogram. So, the final specific volume of the steam from the pressure volume relationship for the polytropic process. And from the steam table at the P2 equal to 1.5 bar, VG2 equal to 1.159 meter cube per kilogram, HF2 equal to 467.1 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2226.3 kilojoules per kilogram, SF2 equal to 1.433 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and SFG2 equal to 5.79 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, properties of the steam, X2 drainage fraction at the end of the process V2 by VG2 this equal to 0.959 divided by 1.159 equal to 0.83. We calculate enthalpy H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2 which is 467.1 plus 0.83 into 2226.3 which is 2314.93 kilojoules per kilogram. S2 equal to entropy S2 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2 which is 1.433 plus 0.83 into 5.79 equal to 6.2387 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And we calculate work done from the for the polytropic process W equal to M into P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by N minus 1. So, substituting all the values 0.8 mass equal to 0.8 into 15 bar 1500 into 0.152 minus 1.5 bar 150 kilopascal into 0.959 divided by 1.25 minus 1 equal to 269.28 kilojoules. So, that is the work done for the process. And the change in internal energy delta U equal to M into H2 minus H1 minus P2 V2 minus P1 V1. So, 0.8 into 2314.93 minus 2923.5 minus P2 V2 150 into 0.959 minus 1500 into 0.152 calculating delta U equal to minus of 419.5 kilojoules. And the heat transfer Q equal to W plus delta U which is 269.28 minus 419.5 equal to minus of 150.2 kilojoules. That is, the heat is rejected. And the change in entropy delta S equal to M into S2 minus S1 is equal to 0.8 into 6.2387 minus 6.71 equal to minus of 0.37 kilojoules per Kelvin. And we take example number 11 from the anionic question paper November 2013. A 280 mm diameter cylinder is fitted with a frictionless leak proof piston contains 0.2 kilogram of steam at a pressure of 0.6 megapascal and a temperature of 200 degrees Celsius. As the piston moves slowly outward through a distance of 305 millimeter, the steam undergoes fully resisted expansion during which the steam pressure and volume are related as PV to the power N equal to constant, where N is a constant. polytropic index. The final pressure of the steam is 0.12 megapascal. So determine the value of the N polytropic index. You have to calculate the work done by the steam, magnitude and direction of heat transfer. So this is the polytropic process, polytropic expansion process, where diameter of the cylinder is 0.28 meter, length of the stroke length equal to 0.305 meter, mass of the steam equal to 0.2 kilogram, pressure P1 equal to 0.6 megapascal which is 6 bar, T1 equal to 200 degrees Celsius, P2 equal to 0.12 megapascal which is 1.2 bar. So from the steam table at the P1 equal to 6 bar, T1 equal to 200 degrees Celsius, it is superheated steam. H1 equal to 2849.7 kilojoules per kilogram and specific volume V1 equal to 0.352 meter cube per kilogram. And initial volume V1 equal to M into specific volume, mass into specific volume, which is 0.02 into 0.352 equal to 0.00704 meter cube. The piston displacement volume Vs equal to pi by 4 d square into L, which is pi by 4 into 0.28 square into 0.305 equal to 0.188 meter cube. And final volume equal to initial volume plus displacement volume. So V2 equal to V1 plus Vs. So 0.00704 plus 0.0188 equal to 0.02584 meter cube. The value of the polytropic index. So P1 V1 to the power N equal to P2 V2 to the power N. So rearranging the terms, N equal to logarithmic of P1 by P2 divided by logarithmic of V2 by V1. So, substituting logarithmic of 0.6 divided by 0.12 divided by logarithmic of V2 equal to 0.02584 divided by 0.00704 equal to 1.24. So, the polytropic index equal to 1.24. And the work done during this expansion process, W equal to P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by N minus 1. So, 600 into 0.00704 minus 120 into 0.02584 divided by 1.24 minus 1, which is 4.68 kilojoules. And from the steam table at 1.24, Vg equal to 1.4283 meter cube per kilogram, Hf equal to 439.3 kilojoules per kilogram, and Hfg equal to 2244.1 kilojoules per kilogram. And the final drainage fraction, so X2 equal to V2 by Vg2. So this V2 specific volume is volume divided by the mass, capital V2 divided by the mass, and the Vg2. So 0.02584 divided by 0.02 into 1.4281 equal to 0.905. So the final drainage fraction of the steam equal to X2 equal to 0.905. Now we calculate the final enthalpy of the steam. H2 equal to Hf2 plus X2 into Hfg2, which is 439.3 plus 0.905 into 2244.1 equal to 2470.2 kilojoules per kilogram, and the heat transfer during this process. So Q equal to W plus delta U. So W plus U2 minus U1. So W plus is U2 M into U2 equal to H2 minus P2 V2 and U1 equal to H1 minus P1 V1. So substituting all the numerical values. So W equal to 4.68 plus mass equal to 0.02 into H2 equal to 2470.2 minus P2 equal to 1.2 into 100 into V2 equal to 1.292 minus H1 equal to 2849.7 minus pressure P1 equal to 6 bar 6 into 100 into 0.352. So calculating using the calculator, Q equal to 4.62 into 0.02 into 2315.616 minus 2638.5 equal to minus of 1.79 kilojoules. So the heat transfer during this process equal to minus of 1.79 kilojoules. That is, the heat is rejected from the steam. And we take example number 12, a large insulated vessel is divided into two chambers, one containing 5 kg of dry saturated steam at 0.2 megapascal and the other contains 10 kg of steam 0.8 quality at and 0.05 megapascal. If the partition is removed and the steam is mixed thoroughly and allowed to settle, find the final pressure steam quality, entropy change in the process. So the given data is given in the depicted in the diagram. So the one chamber is mass of the steam is 5 kilogram. It is dry saturated steam. So x1 equal to 1.0, pressure is 0.2 megapascal. Another chamber contains m2 equal to 10, mass of the steam is 10 kilogram. It is wet steam with the dryness fraction 0.8 and pressure is 0.5 megapascal. So from the steam table at the pressure 0.2 megapascal, which is 2 bar, V1 equal to VG1. So this is dry saturated steam. So V1 equal to VG1 equal to 0.8854 meter cube per kilogram. H1 equal to HG1 equal to 2706.3 kilojoules per kilogram. S1 equal to SG1 equal to 7.12 kilojoules per kilogram. And U1 equal to internal energy, U1 equal to H1 minus P1 V1. So U1 equal to 2706.3 minus 200 into 0.8854 equal to 2529.22 kilojoules per kilogram. 2529.22 kilojoules per kilogram. And from the steam table, P2 equal to 0.5 megapascal, which is 5 bar. VG2 equal to 0.37466 meter cube per kilogram. HF2 equal to 640.1 kilojoules per kilogram. HFG2 equal to 2107.4 kilojoules per kilogram. SF2 from the steam table 1.86 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And SFG2 equal to 4.959 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And we calculate the volume of the steam, specific volume of the steam, V2 equal to X2 into VG2, which is 0.8 into 0.37488 equal to 0.2999 meter cube per kilogram. Enthalpy of the steam H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 640.1 plus 0.8 into 2107.4 equal to 2326.02 kilojoules per kilogram. And the internal energy U2 equal to H2 minus P2 V2, which is 2326.02 minus 500. P2 is 500 into 0.2999 equal to 2176.07 kilojoules per kilogram. And the entropy S2 equal to SF2 plus X2 SFG2 equal to 1.86 plus 0.8 into 4.959 equal to 5.872 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. All the properties at the final condition 5 bar wet steam with the dryness fraction 0.8. Now the total volume of the mixer V equal to V1 plus V2. So volume of the first chamber, volume of the second chamber. Volume of the first chamber equal to M1 into V1, volume of the second chamber equal to M2 into V2. So, M1 equal to 5 into V1 equal to 0.88554 plus 10 into 0.2999 equal to 7.426 meter cube. So, the final volume of the container is 7.426 meter cube and the total mass of the mixer equal to M1 plus M2 equal to 15 kilogram. The final specific volume of the mixer is Vm equal to capital V divided by M. So, capital V equal to 7.426 divided by M equal to 15 equal to 0.495 meter cube per kilogram. The specific volume of the mixer is 0.495 meter cube per kilogram. And similarly, specific volume of the specific enthalpy of the mixer, Hm equal to M1H1 plus M2H2 divided by M, which is M into 2706.3, 5 into 2706.3 plus 10 into 2326.02 divided by 15 equal to 2452.78 kilojoules per kilogram. Now, using the Mollier chart for the, we know the two properties, enthalpy of the mixer equal to 2452.78 and the specific volume of the mixer is 0.495. Using these two properties, locating the 0.3, right, locating the 0.3, we will find the pressure P equal to 3.5 bar, X equal to 0.87, and entropy S3 S equal to 6.29 kilojoules per kilogram. So, here S3 equal to this is 6.29, X equal to 0.87 and pressure P equal to 3.5 bar. And the change in entropy of the mixer for mixing process, delta S equal to M into S. So, mass of the final, total mass of the mixer into entropy of the mixer minus M1 S1 plus M2 S2. So, 15 into 6.29 minus 5 into 7.12 plus 10 into 5.8272 equal to 0.478 kilojoules per Kelvin. There is a change in the entropy of the mixer. So, the question here in the problem, you have to calculate the final pressure, steam quality, and then change in entropy of the process. So the final pressure is 3.5 bar, final quality is 0.87, and change in entropy is 0.478 flow joules per Kelvin. So we stop here. So these are all the reference books I used for preparing the slides. So you can also refer to it for additional information or additional problems. You can write to my mail ID for all queries. I will answer your questions correctly at right time. Thank you for watching. We'll meet again in the next lecture.